Greetings, fellow nerds. Normally to dry chemicals, you just leave them out or heat them up. But some chemicals, like this dysprosium nitrate, are so hygroscopic that they continually absorb water from the air and remain liquid even after months. Even worse, you can't heat it up to dry because it decomposes even with slight heating. For these extremely delicate chemicals, you'll need a device called a desiccator. In this video, we'll make a desiccator bag. The process is brutally simple. First, get a plastic soft drink container and cut it down to approximately the same height as the chemical containers you intend to use. Make sure it's completely dry. Now fill it halfway with a drying agent. You can use beads of silica gel or sodium hydroxide. I personally prefer sodium hydroxide since it also absorbs acidic gases like nitrogen dioxide, hydrogen chloride, and carbon dioxide. Now simply place both the substance you want to dry and the drying agent in the same resealable bag and make sure it's airtight. What happens is the drying agent is much more hygroscopic than your target chemical, so it will make the air in the bag so dry that your target chemical will be forced to start drying out. After a week or two, the target chemical is dry. And there it is. Now sometimes the top part of the chemical dries out before the bottom part, so you should poke your chemical with a glass rod and grind it. If it's still mushy underneath, then grind it thoroughly to expose as much of it as possible, and then put it back in the bag. Repeat this process as often as needed. To save time, you can also put multiple substances in the same bag as long as any gases they produce and their solvents are the same type. Eventually, when you grind them, they should crumble into solid, dry powders. Now, the drying agent itself will not last forever. In the case of sodium hydroxide, the indication is pretty obvious. If it liquefies, it should be replaced. And if it starts eating through its container like this, it definitely needs to be replaced, as well as the container. Silica gel that has blue color indicator beads will turn pink when they're done. In the case of uncolored beads, you'll just need to eyeball it and replace the beads when it stops drying properly. So that's how you make a desiccator bag. Not the coolest thing, but extremely important if you're serious about chemistry. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, rate, and comment.